1939, a new world war begins in Europe. Nazi Germany takes over Czechoslovakia and invades Poland. Denmark and Norway are next. The armies of Belgium, the Netherlands, and Luxembourg are routed by the Wehrmacht, and yet more countries are devoured by the Third Reich. The French government surrenders on the 22nd of June, 1940. The British Expeditionary Force, crushed on the battlefield, barely escapes at Dunkirk. Germany is victorious yet again, and World War II enters a new stage. Great Britain remains the only country in Europe that stands against Nazi Germany. Britons never will be slaves. Separated from mainland Europe by the English Channel, the British Isles are temporarily safe from the German Blitzkrieg. Britain is fully aware that the first strike will come from the air. It is well prepared for that. A complex defensive infrastructure of detection, command, and control, known as the Dowding System, gives the Royal Air Force a serious advantage. The RAF is a multinational force, with pilots not only from the British Commonwealth, but also from Poland, Czechoslovakia, France, Belgium, and other British allies. By the 13th of July, 1940, Hitler personally approves Operation Sea Lion, calling for a full-scale invasion of the United Kingdom. Sir Winston Churchill, the British Prime Minister, responded with the famous speech, "We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender." Within days, thousands of German bombers and fighters would set course for England to try to break the British resistance. A handful of young men in the Royal Air Force would stand between Hitler and the total domination of Europe. Never in the field of human conflict had so much depended on so few.
Altitude 1,500. Speed 185. Over. Roger. I'm almost out of fuel. I can't keep waiting for you. You lost. Proceed to Dover. The Luftwaffe won't hang around to wait. You lost. Proceed to Dover. The Luftwaffe won't hang around to wait. Dover. See Dover Castle to the left? Almost 1,000 years old, that is. They call it the key to England.
I know. I went to that place when I was at school.
Attention, Tuck. This is Flying Fish. The Navy reports 2 German bombers inbound. Do you read? Over.
Roger. I have you loud and clear. Only 2. Must be stragglers.
Let's go get them.
Right. Do you have them?
I have them. Going in.
Beginning to like this. Should I go?
Tuck, right. This is Ace McKellar. I'll be confirming your victories. Good show. Now return to base. We'll take it from here. Over.
Roger. Returning to base. Thank you, sir.
Extract from the diary of Owen Wright, July 10th, 1940. They called me up today. I was so excited to be finally fighting for my beloved Britain. I forgot my lucky scarf. The Nazi Air Force is even greater than I imagined from the French reports. I've never seen so many planes in the sky at once. I think it's exhilarating, but also terribly scary. My fellow RAF pilots saved me on more than one occasion. I'm thankful they did. What would my poor mother say if I was shot down on my maiden wartime flight? It doesn't look as though the Huns will stop their relentless onslaught, so hopefully I've done enough to prove my worth and get called up again by Corporal Tuck. I must remember to take my scarf. I have a feeling I'll need it next time.
Our mission is to defend Royal Navy ships, the destroyer HMS Cossack and some transports just north of Dover. They'll be our first objective. Light cruiser Glasgow is north of them. It's our second objective. Contraption below. That's the radar. Fighter Command has its eyes and ears. It can see the Luftwaffe all the way across the channel. them.
I'm leading the bombers. We need assistance here. I have a 109 on my tail. Help! I can't shake him. Someone help, please!
Somebody attack that target!
Okay.
Here at full throttle, and the place is deserted.
Tally-ho! There they are, coming in from the east!
Somebody! Take care of that
appreciate it. I presume you'll now return to the track.
Wright's diary, July 13, 1940. I can't get the thought of drowning men out of my head. Luckily up there we can't really see what goes on when a ship is sunk, but I can imagine the terror. We've just been told HMS Cossack made it to its final destination, but I know that too many others didn't. We tried our best, but it was next to useless. The Luftwaffe are just too great in number. For every plane I shot out of the sky, three more took its place. I don't know what to do. None of us do. We're tired and angry. This feels like suicide. I've been stuck at the airbase and unable to continue to fight. We try and pass the time by playing dominoes, but I'm useless. And I've already lost my sweet ration for the rest of the week to Richie Llewellyn. He's a bit of a hustler.
Shoreline. Destroyer. Must be part of a group. Stand by for my orders. Locate it. Sink it. Jolly good. Let's get to work. They won't bother anyone now. Attention! A German naval squadron is harassing our ships due north. Watch out, they have air cover.
Thank you.
Outstanding. Time to return to base. Good show. Now let's help out our fighters. Let's get a couple of Jerry fighters.
flight of enemy bombers.
Somebody protect that target!
Affirmative.
We've located a large formation of HC-111s. All squadrons scramble to intercept. We must force the bombers to jettison their payloads, so we'll turn back home. Our objective is to damage the bombers.
Somebody attack that target!
Owen Wright's diary, August 8, 1940. We joined forces with the 46th Squadron today, and there is a fair bit of banter and competition amongst the ranks. Of course, we're all on the same side when we get up there, and we had a whole armada of German bombers to share. I'll have to ride home to Mother soon and make sure Uncle Bernard is okay. A worrying amount of planes were shot down over farmland, but as the corporal said, it was better there than in the city. On the way home, we were radioed to change course and head back to the coast to protect the HMS Glasgow. Damn, those Junker 87s are tough with their extra armor. Took me a full 10 minutes just to shoot one down. My good friend Billy Andrews wasn't so lucky. They're writing to his family now. I won't let them write a letter to mine. On June 22, 1941, Germany began Operation Barbarossa, a large-scale invasion of the Soviet Union. The Red Army suffered catastrophic losses in the first days of conflict. During the next few months, the Red Army would be in a constant retreat. The Wehrmacht would quickly take over recent Soviet acquisitions in the Baltic and Western Ukraine, and move still deeper into Moldavia, Belarus, the rest of the Ukraine, and large portions of European Russia. Leningrad, Russia's second largest city, was surrounded. Germany was advancing on all fronts and getting dangerously close to Moscow itself. By winter, things begin to change. Russian resistance finally stiffens, aided by the harshest Russian winter in decades. The German war machine falters and rolls back. A year after the invasion, the war had taken a terrible toll on the Soviet Union. Millions of people had been killed or enslaved. Countless villages, towns, and cities lie in ruins. Germany begins yet another summer offensive, but this time, Russia is better prepared. The city of Stalingrad is about to be the stage of one of history's most brutal battles. The Red Army will not give up the city easily. The Soviet 62nd Army is given the task of stopping the German invaders. Our cause is just. The enemy will be crushed. Victory will be ours.
Lugern are at your disposal. Comrades, today we are patrolling like Stalingrad airspace. The front line is getting closer and closer, so things here can get real hot any minute. Keep your head on a swivel. Don't even blink. Stay close. Provide mutual cover. Don't do anything stupid.
Thank you. Here we go.
Ground observers report 100 plus bombers approaching Salihad.
We don't have enough planes to shoot down that many bombers. That's why I'm suggesting a psychological attack instead.
We'll need to down an entire flight in any single pass. That should get the entire formation to panic.
Extract from the diary of Andrew Dunlop, August 23rd, 1942. German forces are getting closer to Stalingrad all the time. They shall not pass. Not on my watch. I gathered my best crew and we took up the I-16s. They may be old, but they're still outmaneuvering a Messerschmitt anytime. It was impossible to say how many Messerschmitts flooded the sky. But one by one, we shot them down in the longest and toughest battle of my career. I can't remember ever being so physically exhausted in a cockpit. To make matters worse, after disposing of the 109s, the Henkels arrived. By this time, I was surviving on adrenaline alone. And although we couldn't possibly defeat them all, we sent the survivors back to base with their Nazi tails between their legs. We don't have such luxuries as a hot bath, but my head will be glad for a dirty pillow tonight.
Manchenko, recon group, brought back some intel. Three of his men died to bring us info on two enemy air bases. Their sacrifices will not be in vain. Today we'll conduct active reconnaissance over the airfields. If the intel is confirmed, our bombers will hit the targets with everything they got.
everyone else.
Plywood or something. The flak is real enough, though.
Why don't we erase this dummy airfield off the map? Somebody else might get confused. Number of aircraft, the airfield is operational.
Transmitting to headquarters.
HQ requests we deal with the flak here before the bombers go in.
Let's make it easy for them.
Thank you. I see some planes from the 788th Squadron. Our Spanish comrades serve there. Let's tune into their frequency.
The new base. Otherwise, we're looking at a large number of unwelcome visitors. You're clear to land.
Superiority in the area. However, the surrounded German 6th Army continue to be resupplied by air. Our mission is to put an end to their air bridge. We must destroy any Luftwaffe aircraft which attempt to land inside the pocket. Otherwise, victory at Stalingrad could be very long.
Roger, proceed to the next group. Yes, that's Deutschland.
Comrades, we now have air superiority in the area. However, the surrounding German 6th Army continue to be resupplied by air. Our mission is to put an end to their air bridge. We must destroy any Luftwaffe aircraft which attempt to land inside the pocket. Otherwise, victory at Stalingrad could be very long.
Starboard!
Starboard! They made it in here!
Spoil them!
Andrew Dunlop's diary, January 15th, 1943.
Night flying is always a challenge, especially when trying to pick Junkers up using searchlights alone. Stopping German supplies was crucial, however, and this was our chance to cut off their lifeblood and starve them out like the rats they are. We took Potomac mostly thanks to the infantry, but not before we had destroyed the perimeter guns. When attacking IL-2s, German fighters closely watch what our pilots are doing. If anyone begins to act nervous, zigzagging or pushing ahead or falling behind, the Krauts rush right in. Stalingrad is back in Soviet hands where it belongs. This day will be remembered for a long time. And tonight, my squadron will drink and celebrate our most famous victory of all. The United States entered World War II after the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor on the 7th of December, 1941. U.S. forces first fought the Germans in the North African campaign, and the victory at El Alamein paved the way for the long-awaited invasion of Europe. British Prime Minister Winston Churchill and U.S. President Franklin Delano Roosevelt met in Casablanca in January 1943 to plan the Italian campaign. After a few days of talks, it was decided that the invasion should begin in Sicily. Sicily was defended by the Italian Sixth Army. Benito Mussolini, the Italian Prime Minister, was the Italian Commander-in-Chief. The Italian campaign began in June 1943 with a large-scale operation commanded by General Dwight Eisenhower. To prepare for the invasion of Sicily, several outlying islands were invaded by a combined force of British, Canadian, and American armed forces. By 11th of June, the Italian garrison of the island of Pantelleria had surrendered to the Allies. The islands of Lampedusa, Linosa, and Lampione surrendered on the 12th and the 13th. The ease of these operations made the Allies optimistic about the future of the campaign, and the islands became important airfields and staging areas for the upcoming Operation Husky. The loss of the islands had the opposite effect on Mussolini. He said, "This is the wake-up call, or rather, a knock on the door." However, despite all this, both sides knew that the most difficult part was still ahead. The Allies would need to launch amphibious and airborne assaults right into the hornet's nest.